Okay then. My piece de resistance, the greatest thing I've ever built. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best of Slot, and we are back playing Minecraft Dinosaurs. And in today's video, we are going to work on the Sarcosuchus exhibit. We're also going to work on something else. I've had a little bit of an idea. So, if we're going to build the Sarcosuchus exhibit, we are going to want sand. That's why I got these shovels, just in case. We're going to want some cobblestone. We're going to build a dam kind of thing. For some reason I can't remember, but that was the plan. So we're gonna do that. And somebody actually suggested this. We're gonna grab some skull blocks as well, just in case. And we should have some meat in here. We could do with some food. Let's go cook that bad boy up. Right. Oh, another thing I want to do. People keep mentioning it, and I keep forgetting. I did check how the plants work. I didn't realize this is what you had to do. But if we grab ourselves a bucket. There is my bucket. I'm actually going to want a few. Keep all the buckets. We're going to want all the buckets. Grab some milk. Go into our paleo box, as it is right here, and grab a plant like the paleo rafe. And then go over here to the ana. Nope, not the analyzer. But there we go. Hey, all my plants are getting analyzed. Lucky so and so's. I wonder what it feels like being analyzed. Oh, no. God, wrong box. No. Travesty. No. There we go. So we're going to stick these in the culture vat, like so. Now I'm assuming, because it's plants rather than the animals, it, like, one bucket of milk goes a lot further, but I don't really know for sure. But we're going to leave that to kind of do its thing for a little bit. There is one other thing I want to do. I've been farming a little bit. I've done a little bit of work. If you check the map, you'll see... Oh, the barn. We'll go check on the barn. I've actually been working on the barn for the first time in a super long time. What was I going to do with my entire life? Dangerous questions there. You know what? I don't have a bloody clue. I was about to do something. We needed leather. We needed leather. Now, I'm sure I got leather. Yes, I did get some leather. Right, how do we make... A lead, I've forgotten. I need two pieces of string. I've only got one piece of string. Okay, can we make string? That's the question then. Okay, we just need a little bit of wool. A little bit. I'm sure I have wool. So plenty of wool. There we go. Good stuff. And you'll see why. I've had a little bit of a plan, you see. I've had a little bit of an idea. So we need to make a lead. Boop, boop. Lovely stuff. Let's grab that. That's why we've got this cobblestone as well. And I think we're looking good. Let's put this rubbish away. Check in on our plantaronies. How are we doing, lads? This is taking much longer than I expected. Substantially longer. But I figure we can use that in maybe the Ceratosaurus exhibit or something like that. I don't really know. But let's have a little explore. It's been a while since we've checked in on everyone. There's our Ankylosaurus over there with big old tempo. I think the Anky still needs to grow. I don't know. Maybe that's full size. If we head over here, I'll show you what I did in the barn. It's definitely not finished. Oh, actually. Well, right click, right, yeah. My bad. I'm going to grab the wheat, and you'll see why in a moment. Don't you go... No, it's my wheat. Mine. I think I need to fence this off. I don't know if it is a thing that animals can eat your plants, but I've definitely lost some. I don't think I've been jumping on it for, like, the first time ever. We're just going to nip back super quickly. I already checked this earlier. Let's put the seeds away. What we want to do is head over to our crafting table, like so, and do this. Okay, give me a minute. There we go. It's a lot of work to get a few hay bales, but we've got some hay bales, which I think are going to look really cool in the barn. So, yeah. Okay, moving on. Shut the door. Actually, there's quite a lot I want to show. I've done a lot more work than I expected. I don't know why, I was in a weird mood this morning. I kind of stuck on YouTube, listened to some, like, 90s classic cheesy rock pop stuff, and then just kind of got to work, I guess. Yeah, I've done a little bit of work over here. It's definitely not done, but I've put all the grass back in, I've put a river in, I've put, like, a little log thing in. It looks a lot nicer. Put some trees in. It does look generally a lot nicer. It's never going to be my, never going to be my favourite exhibit, but I think it looks a lot nicer already. And they also killed like 20 pigs. You'll notice that's why we got loads of meat. I went through basically every exhibit and killed the pigs, the sheep, and just murdered everything. Right, yes, the barn. It's definitely not completely ready, but I've done a little bit. You can kind of see them already. There's some stalls now. There's six of them or something like that. I'd like to put like a gate on them somehow to block each one off individually so that we can put quaggas in there and stuff like that. And they also put in some. What would you call that? What would you even call that? Scaffolding? No. Roof wood. It's roof wood, okay? I was a little bit hesitant at first because it blocks off the glass, but I actually think I quite like it. I'm not sure that's going to be the final design. I kind of want it to maybe come up a little bit in the middle, but I think it... I don't know, the whole place just has like a little bit more personality, right? It looks a little bit more interesting because of the roof wood. I really can't remember what it's called. It's going to bug the bejeebus out of me. Oh, right, yeah, the hay. Let's just go stick this down. So the idea is we'll make quite a lot of this. I'll start farming up the wheat where possible. And like at the back... Each, we'll do it neater than that, but just at the back of each exhibit, a little bit, we'll have like a little stack of hay, pretending that's what our quaggers are feeding on and stuff like that. Have a little gate at the front, and yeah, I think that's pretty cool. Oh, one thing we need to do as well, bloody Nora, we need to make ourselves a feeder because we want to feed our Sarcosuchuses. Okay, I'm gonna. One day I will remember. It is not this day. It is not this day. You done? You were taking way longer than I expected. Okay, we need a bucket. We need some. Do I have any stone left? Yeah, I got none that's out of sight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need 2 pieces of glass. Yeah, no. 1 piece of glass. And some iron. There we go. Good stuff. Okay. Once again, can we remember? So, lovely stuff. And we'll grab a little bit of meat. Can't go wrong with a bit of meat, folks. Just give them, yeah, they can have the pork chops, that's fine. Right. Bloody Nora. I'm pretty sure I'm dying, by the way. Just, like, as a general thing, I feel people should know, like, if I randomly disappear, I'm dead. That's just the case. Right, we're going to put this feeder down, and then we are going to work on the Sarcosuchus exhibit. I want to put in like a nice little beach area and stuff like that, but there's something else I want to do as well. But there they are, looking lovely. They kind of just, they spend a lot of their time just chilling on the side. They look really, really, really cool. I'll give them that much. They really do look awesome. Look at them. That's awesome. Yeah. That's so exciting to me. I don't know why. You see, I've blocked this up. This is where the cave was. I've also blocked up. Because remember, we had a little babby, kind of got stuck down there. If we head down here, I think it's around here. But there was a hole in the ground there, and it went down. You remember, like, in the Dilophosaurus exhibit where the water is, and it kind of leads down into a cave? It led down to an even bit. It was a huge cave, an absolutely monstrously large cave down there. And it seemed like a bad idea. You know what I'm thinking right now, though? The Sarcosuchuses, they don't go in the water. They really don't. They spend all their time on the side, right? I mean, they can go in the water and they'll get back out. I wonder if I can push one in. I try to prove my point. There we go. So they'll go swimming and stuff. They, you know, they're fine with it, but they don't seem to actively choose to go into the water, basically. So what I'm thinking is we can do our first, well, second, I guess, joint exhibit. We've got some... Oh. I know we want to make an aquarium, but I'm thinking maybe we can make, like, the coelacanths or something like that. Maybe dig out the river a little bit more. I really like this. Maybe dig out the river a little bit more and then just fill it up with some prehistoric animals. I thought that'd be pretty cool. So the one thing we want to do here is A, get some water for this bit. So that looks silly. Give me a minute. Oh no. I should be able to take from this bit, right? Surely? I've already gone disastrous. Yeah, it's fine, it's fine. Come on, you. Can't have those little wibbly-wobbly bits. I'm all for wibbly-wobbly bits in general, but not in my exhibits. Right, so I'm thinking we make this area sort of sandy. I don't know where we're going to put... I don't really know what my viewing for this exhibit is going to look like quite yet. You know, how do we look at this exhibit? How do we look into it? We could just do sort of a pathway across the top, but I'd like to come up with something... Oh, there you go. Where's the other one gone? Has he gone for a swim? Maybe they do go swimming. They go swimming or they've disappeared. There's really no alternative. Oh, I love it. Very, very cool. Little chirpy noises. Just like a crocodile. Right, anyways, yes, I was going to give them a feeder. I was just trying to think where I want to put it, but I think he is fine. It's like on the coast. There we go.
Yeah, I just want to make it more sandy, so we're going to go grab some sand, unless we've got a billion buckets. Oh, there's something else. Oh, God. Something else I want to show you. I've got so many ideas. Something else I want to show you guys. This was really, really cool. I've never seen this before. We're going to head over to the... Maybe like that. We're going to head over to the Dilophosaurus exhibit. Nip past Therry, who's like one of the only ones who's giving me no trouble. There's a few too many rams in there for my liking. We may need to hop in there and sort that out. There's my bouncing pig, and if we head down into our Dilo exhibit, which I think has a ladder. Did I put a ladder on here? Actually, I definitely didn't put a ladder on here, did I? Oopsie daisy. Oh, we'll figure it out. Yeah, I just want to show you guys something. This is really cool. I've never seen any of animals do this. I'm sure they do, but if we go into this exhibit and we hit... Okay, perfect. I'm going to hit this pig, right? Look at him go! Look at him go! This... Do it again. I was wondering where the other one was. Oh, he just died. But yeah, it's one hit and then the Dilophosaurus actually go in and they try to hunt. Look at them all going circling around the ram in the middle trying to get hold of him. I just thought it was really cool. They're all hunting him right now. They can't get to him because he's in the water. I didn't know that was a mechanic, so I don't know. I thought it was pretty cool. Go get him, get him, get him! Yeah! Isn't that cool? I was dead chuffed with that. I didn't know it was a thing. Check on their feed and make sure they're okay, and then we shall head out. I actually had to rebuild quite a lot of this exhibit. Oh god, that's a problem. You guys okay? How hungry are you? No, you're fine. You must have only just finished. Put some torches in here as well. Let's just put all this in there. They deserve it, you know? They helped hunt down. Let's try to sneak out of here. Did you guys breed? Is that a thing? I don't... What? What? Can dinosaurs breed in this game? Is that actually a thing? So little. Okay. While they're distracted, I need to get out. Unfortunately, that does require doing this. Quickly, quickly. I really need a better way to get in and out of here. But we'll come to that in a little bit, I'm sure. Right. I am on peaceful at the moment. I was going to say, yeah, this massive golem thing spawned over here and it stole all the blocks. It stole like 20 blocks from inside my build. If you see a missing block like this one, for example, it's because a bloody golem stole them. So I turned on peaceful to get rid of the stone. So put in some lights over here at the Stratosaurus exhibits. They're looking a little bigger. They've got these kind of white patterning over the head now, but only on this one, which is interesting. So there must be a bit of a gender difference between the two. Lit it all up, done my favourite thing, which is, you know, putting the torches inside the trees. Always pretty cool, I think. Yeah, they're looking good. Right, so 15 minutes in, we've built nothing. What we're gonna do, we're gonna head down here. Now you'll see I've done a little bit of work over here at the Mosasaurus exhibit. Basically all I've done is surround it with stone, just to make it feel like a bit more of a walkway kind of thing. So you can walk along the whole thing like this. Also got rid of that little viewing area we had here. I decided it sucks. So we got rid of that. Now, if we drop down, I just want to show you this because this looks really cool to me. I think we only saw it last episode from within the glass tunnel, which, don't get wrong, I'm very talented and the glass tunnel looks amazing, but that looks pretty cool. This is why we wanted the glowstone, right? For this right here. I know. Look, you're fed. Just chill. That's cool though, right? And you can see the glass tunnel in the distance. Popping along like that. I really, really like this. It looks great there as well. I have extended it a little bit, the other tunnel. You can see it pops out a little bit if it pops out about there now, but I'm still trying to think about what we're going to do here. I really don't know. I don't know if maybe if we bring the glass wall just down here and we do another exhibit here, and then I really don't want to do this glass tunnel all the way around. It's going to take way too long. We're talking probably literally tens of hours to do that in survival mode. So I think we'll probably bring the glass wall down from these two sandy bits and just have this little area here where we have one exhibit, two exhibit, and then we can build like a bigger exhibit thing over here, but maybe less with the glass tunnels. Maybe we'll have like a little boat, we'll have a little dock area, and we'll be able to do a little journey or something like that. Who knows? But, so my idea was, apologies if I die every now and again, is to build something like... We're basically going to build a crane again like we did with the pig. Oh, I didn't make a fence post. Okay, what we need to do is open the lamp. Oh, no, I don't want that. Just want that. Okay, we're just going to nip back to the lab. Pew! Ugh! What is... Ugh! I'm getting real, real tired of my culture vats being destroyed. It's really, really annoying. Like, I'm all on board with the evil plant. I really am. Like, I'm down with the evil plant. But, yeah, mildly annoying. Oh, yeah, yeah, right. So what are we going to do? We're going to get a fish, weren't we? Where the fish? I think the sealer counts. I don't know what we'll do for inside the house then. Oh, I don't know. Yeah, screw it. We're going to put the sealer counts in. I'm just thinking... Okay. Culture. Yeah, what was I thinking? I was definitely thinking things. Imagine things do that. We'll get more DNA down the line. We've still got the Nautiluses. I just think it'll be pretty cool to mix things up a little bit. So that's what we're going to do. Right, we need a bucket of water. Let's go grab some of that. Shut up, phone. This is why I don't screw around with plants. They're evil. I've always felt that. Always. Even when I was a baby, I came out and I was like, Mum, Dad... Was my dad even there? Oh, let's not go there. Who knows? Mum, doctor man, nurse woman. Oh god, that's a bit sexist, wasn't it? Jesus. To be fair, this was 28 years ago, so the chances... Eh. But still, don't like that was my default. Anyways, what are we doing? Glass, we need glass. For zwei vier pieces of glass. Glass and... Afton. I don't know what glass is in German, okay? If that wasn't obvious. Anyways, yes. Midwife person or mid-husband. Is midwifery... I know it's called midwifery, by the way, which is the worst word in the world instead of midwifery. Midwifery sounds fine. Midwifery sounds terrible. It scares the life out of me somehow. I'm not making much sense today. I'll give myself that much. What was I going to say? Is it a midwife and a mid-husband, or is the wife just... the term that's kept. I haven't really thought about that before. I've never known a male midwife, I'm not going to lie. Not that I know particularly many midwives, either. Midwifes. What goes over there? Oh, the bucket. There we go. Oh, wrong way around. Okay. For once, will you just be cool? Look, this poor girl has squeezed out so many bodily fluids for your amusement, and you keep... making it worse. Just be cool. Right. God, I love the teleport. God, I love the brachiosaurus. It's huge. God, I love the brachiosaurus. So yeah, kind of like in Jurassic World, where they hang the shark over the middle and the Mosasaurus jumps up to eat it. You know, big scene at the start of Jurassic World. We're going to do the same. I mean, the Mosasaurus won't jump and it's going to look bizarre because the pig will bounce up and down, but I still think I want to do it because I like a bouncy pig. What can I say? What we're gonna do, I think this will work. So my plan to get the pig over there is just to build like a little stone bridge that goes out into the middle of the exhibit, take us underneath the crane a bit. Doesn't look like a crane, but we can pretend. And then we can attach a fence post and we can attach a pig. Bouncy, bouncy pig. It just has such a hellish life, this pig. Well, it's just, imagine just perpetually bouncing. Okay, let's try to phrase this a little bit better. Perpetually being hung up by a leash over a Mosasaurus exhibit, just waiting for the day that the AI randomly decides it's capable of killing you. We're gonna have to jump up to do it, but that'll do. Oh, it's raining. Oh, it's been a while. I really missed the storm mod. It caused tons of problems and it was laggy as balls, but it was really nice having those random storms every now and again. We may bring it back. This is the first time it's rained in ages. Absolutely ages. Right, we need to nip back home. We need to... No, not to home. We need to go to lab. We need ourselves a fence piece. Thingamajiggy. I'll go for a double, I think. It's funny. Part of me is like, well, I'm here doing YouTube and stuff like that. Maybe I can use it as like a therapy session for things, you know? And then you think, Yeah, well, you're kind of pretending to be a professional YouTuber. Maybe you should just focus on talking to YouTube and being entertaining. Best of luck, you freaking idiot. It's hard sometimes. I think people don't understand sometimes that... Don't get me wrong, I'm very lucky to have this job. I really am. It's an amazing job, and compared to how much some people work, I really don't put that many hours in. Sometimes. Most times, if I'm honest. I have to find a different pig. I need a land pig, not a sea pig. Unfortunately, I did murder most of the land pigs, so we have a slight issue here. But, I don't know, man. The one problem, the one hard bit about the job is if you're not in a... I mean, I'm in a good mood right now, but if you're not in a good mood, if you're having a rough day, if there's stuff going on, you kind of have to, or at least others do, I really make no pretense about myself, but for most people, you kind of have to, you know, what's up, guys? This is Blargon 6 coming at you from... Where am I coming at you from? Switzerland, for reasons. Coming at you from Swiss town, and you know, all that kind of shit. Oh god, I swore. I'm so sorry. And I don't know. I don't know how people do it. I find it hard. Pig! Okay, well that went well. I don't want to lose all of the pigs. I think I might lose all of the pigs. Right, let's get this pig instead. Come here. Come here. Come on, buddy. Come on. What the pig? Come here. Thank you. Right, let's go. Come. I know it's raining, right? I know. Nobody likes it. I actually love the rain, but that's not the point. Come on. I'm kind of sad. Winter's like basically over by this point. I think winter is actually... We're firmly into spring, right? Because it's like Easter weekend. And the rains have stopped. And it's slowly getting up obnoxiously warm once again. I'm going to have to move. I think I need like a holiday home. Like most people get holiday home in like the south of France or something. So then when it gets colder in winter, they go to France. I'm thinking I need a holiday home to escape the summer. That sounds like a much better idea to me. You know, just move to, I don't know, Canada or something every summer for 6 months. Oh, Canada can get really warm as well. I need maybe Iceland? I don't know how warm Iceland gets. I imagine not that warm. You're going to be okay here. Oh, well done, Piggy. I'm kind of proud of him right now. Okay. Now I need to get up there. It's going to be interesting. Be back in a minute, pig. You know what? I cannot remember how I did this. Ow. Okay, I'm going to try to make this more of a... staircase. Maybe we can get the pig up here a little bit. Come on, piggy. There we go. Who's a good piggy? There we go. Alright, it must have been a distance thing. Oh! Mosasaurus. No, thank you. Does anyone here live in Iceland? Can we be friends? I just want to live at your house for like 6 months out of the year. Is that okay? Not even 6 months, 3 months. All I'm looking was to come live with you for 3 months a year. That doesn't seem like a big deal. That seems like a fairly normal request for a YouTuber to make of his subscribers. I think that's the least you could do for me. God. Nah, it'd be a menace, it's fine. It's a weird day, folks. It's a weird day. I feel like I've said that a lot lately. I feel like every video I have to go, well, it's one of those days. Eventually, you can have so many of those days that it's not those days anymore. If every day is those days, then it's not those days, you know? Then it has to be a very different type of day to be that day. Does that make sense? God only knows. Right. Get rid of that. Okay then. My piece de resistance. The greatest thing I've ever built. Oh, I feel so bad for the pig. It looks bizarre. You know, actually, because you can't see the string, it's actually fairly terrifying, I would say. Bouncing ghost piggy will haunt my dreams for the end of time. I'm gonna nip to bed. We should actually wake up facing Bouncing Ghost Piggy, shouldn't we? Near enough, anyway. Yes, there is Gamp. I don't know what to do with that. I really don't. Right. Unfortunately, we have slightly neglected the, I really need a way down from here. It's really annoying me at this point. Kind of neglected the Sarcosuchus, which was not the idea. Got a little bit of sand, and we've got a little bit of time. Screw it, let's go and just do a little bit. We will finish off the exhibit completely next time, but there isn't that much to do. I still don't really have an idea for how we're going to make it. Oh my god, the pigs. They've really got bigger quickly, haven't they? Jesus, you sleep. You're sleepy, Sarcosuchus. Very cool, very cool. Exactly, buddy. Okay. Let's just nip. I don't know. Where was I going to do this? I kind of want to put sand everywhere, so let's do that. Put that there. And I just think it looks a little better. And we don't really have a sandy. Oh, they're actually adorable for now. Eventually, they're going to get fairly huge, and I think three of them might actually be pushing it a little bit, considering the size of the exhibit, but we'll see. You've just gone to sleep on the feeder. You are me, really, personified. You are amazing. Just fall asleep with your head in the fridge or something. That takes me back. Ah, childhood obesity. Oh god. Right, okay. So I'm just going to put a little bit of sand over here, and I'd love some suggestions. So what do we do to make this exhibit... I mean, it's a nice little exhibit. Oh, the coelacanths. We'll put the coelacanths in the next episode as well. I really am sorry that we haven't got that much done today. I've kind of wanted to catch you guys up on everything that's been going on, and the pig took some effort, if we're honest. It was obviously clearly worth it, but the pig did take some effort. And the Dilophosaurus stuff and the new barn, blah, 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 blah. But. Yeah, so how do we make this interesting to view? That is my question right now. Because I really don't have any ideas other than just a walkway, and that's fine. They don't all have to be super interesting original exhibits in some ways, but if we can come up with something cool, then, you know, why would you not do the cool thing if you can do the cool thing? If given the choice, always do the cool thing, right? That makes a lot of sense. But this already looks nicer. I kind of like it with the sand sort of in between the grass, like so. Oops, busy. Nearly run out, though. We'll just use these last four pieces, and then we will be done. So, next episode, we'll finish this off, but we're going to probably start working on whatever is next. I think we might do the museum next. That's been, like, a project of mine for a while. I think it's going to go up here. Because we kind of need to start expanding out a little bit now. This area has kind of been defined for a long time. We've kind of been shoving extra stuff into the gaps, you know, like the Dilophosaurus exhibit, the hatchery, the underwater hatchery, the Ceratosaurus exhibit, all this stuff here kind of didn't really expand outwards. So I think putting the museum up on the hill, and that kind of pushes us, and it kind of like opens up all this over here. And then maybe the floating islands and stuff like that, and maybe the town, maybe we can... putting like our railway to get over here to the snow area, stuff like that. We'll have a little think about it. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. How do we make the Sarcosuchus exhibit, and what do we do for the next episode? If there is like a museum design that you guys really like, that would be really cool as well. It's probably going to be quite a big project at the museum, so it might be something that we just work on every few episodes whilst we build other exhibits and stuff like that. We'll have to see. But thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers for yourself as always. Bye bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.